After the hard work comes harvest. In this video, we will share with you all that goes into ensuring a successful harvest. You'll get an expert analysis of a harvest process. You'll also learn how to calculate FCR, gross margin, gross profit, and lots more. This video promises to be highly informative, as Mr. Willie Florin once again brings to bear his wealth of experiences in the aquaculture industry. All this time, he stresses on the need for good record keeping and also how you can ensure a profitable fish farming business. I am Dominic Yodu and I'll be your guide through this lecture. Please do well to like this video and subscribe to our channel. We also look forward to getting your feedback in the comment section below. Once more, you're welcome to our channel.
Good morning, Dominic.
Hi, good morning, Mr. Willie. I see you're looking very, very unusual today with your cap. Seems like something wonderful is happening. Can you tell me what is happening exactly in there? What is happening here?
Let me tell you. Today is the moment of truth. Because we are harvesting our catfish.
Moment of truth.
Yes, because when you stock your catfish, this one particular pump we are selling now, yes, we stock 4,500 pieces. At a size of around 80 gram.
Okay.
Later on, you will see our tank reports get exact results.
Yes.
And today, after almost 150 days, I think 140 days, we are harvesting.
Fantastic.
So the moment is good because we have not caught those fish for 140 days. Yes, we have been feeding them, up to maybe 6,000 kilos. And now, we want to find out how much money we have paid. This is the work of 140 days, and now we monetize it.
Beautiful. So what is going on here is
harvest.
Is harvest.
Yes, so what is happening here, we are harvesting here, we're weighing them here on this spot.
Okay.
Then the fish is going to the sales point, which is just 100 meters away.
Interesting. Yeah?
So I don't sell my fish close to the pond. Because I don't want my customers to mess with the rest of the farm.
Yeah? I see.
And also there's another reason for it. We harvest it here, we're weighing them here. Every time when I take 500 kilo, I also do an average weight.
Oh.
So that at the end of the pond, when the pond is finished, I know exactly how many kilo I got for my harvesting. And I got also the average weight. And with the average weight and the total kilo, I also know how many numbers of fish I got back from what I initially stocked.
Mm.
So in other words, the survival rate. Later on, I will show you with mathematics, the calculations, how that all works out.
Interesting, yeah. Interesting. So
this pond actually, you came late.
Okay.
Because we have already harvested over 3,000 kilo from this pond.
Really?
Yes, this pond was a very nice full pond. But of course, by finishing the last fish out of the pond is when I can do my calculation.
Interesting.
Okay.
So, I look forward to seeing what happens next. So,
yes, now they brought the fish to the sales point.
Okay.
We'll go there later.
Okay.
So now they're bringing another 500 kilo.
Okay.
Yeah, they put some water in this container. The guys are coming back. You'll see how they harvest.
Interesting. I'm looking forward to that, sir.
You should know.
By the way, why does your water look so dirty?
The water is not really dirty. It is because the rain has just started.
Okay.
And we're using water from the dam.
Oh.
From the dam, and if you look at the embankment.
Okay.
Yeah. So with the rainfall, the water gets a bit muddy.
Mm.
But muddy doesn't mean that the water is bad.
Oh.
Today, And all our tanks, our mortality rate was very low, maybe 2 or 3 feet only. That's interesting. So we're harvesting here,
okay,
batches of 50 to 60 kilos.
Okay.
Yeah. Wally over there, he's okay. The one doing the records.
Okay. That's the farm manager, right?
He's the farm manager. So he's doing the records, and the first tank of every batch of 500 kilos. We count them one by one, so that we have the average weight.
Oh.
You see this tank over there, Dominique?
Okay. Yeah.
It can contain about 500 kilo. When it's 500 kilo, it goes to the customers.
Interesting. Interesting. So I see this has been weighed already, right?
He has weighed, and now he wants to count them.
Okay.
Yes.
Can I talk with the farm manager?
Of course.
Okay.
Wally, can you
can I just ask a few questions about what just happened?
Let me do it like this. Okay. So I can see the man in action.
Okay.
68.
Hmm. 68.
68, yeah.
Is that a normal range, sir?
No, sometimes it's maybe 70 or 80.
Okay. That's interesting.
So they are counting those fish?
You count
all the fish?
And now they will not tell me the number. Then I will determine the average.
Okay. So aside taking the weight, you also get a count of the fishes.
So you calculate the average. That is the weight divided by the number. It will give you the average weight.
And usually, what do you get as the average weight? What would you consider?
Now we are getting like 1.4.
Oh.
Plus or minus 1.4. But for now it's 1.4 and plus.
I see.
So, Wally, you only do the first bubble of each 500 kilo.
I normally do the first bubble. Yeah, it's not to everything, but I do one randomly.
Okay.
So, how many you have gotten so far, Wally, for today?
I've got 3.3 tons.
You have already, huh?
Yes, I'm
already. And customers are still needing more.
Yes, they need more.
So, how many pieces this time?
4.4. Let's take a
piece. Yes, please calculate your average weight.
Okay, we have a 72 divided by 4.4. The average weight is 1.6.
Wow, these ones are big.
And of course, we are getting to the bottom.
Oh, okay.
Usually, we normally have the big fish
at the end, huh?
Oh.
That's interesting.
Is it because they hide on that or because they are smart during the catch?
And they are stronger.
Usually, that is how we normally see. That the bottom, they are more bigger than the.
It's interesting. Okay. So, Mr. Willy, what is going on here? Where are we now?
Okay, this is the place where we are weighing the fish.
Before that,
we will grade the fish and size it.
Okay.
Bigger fish at a higher price.
than the smaller fish. Some customers they want small ones, some customers they want big ones. So you can see here how they are.
Baba, select the fish.
Oh, I see.
This one is small.
Okay.
Okay.
So who's the young man carrying your book?
Yeah, he's every customer. When they finish, buying, they get an invoice. And it comes from what he's writing down.
Oh, I see. He seems a little busy now, but I would have asked him a couple of questions. Are you?
Yeah.
Okay, Mr. Smith. So how are you able to ensure the records are kept properly and without you missing out? I see a lot of things happening here.
And the fish, they have different sizes.
Yes.
And each customer comes with their own demand based on how the customer out there demands.
Okay.
When they bring the fish scan, I put my hand inside and I sort out the sizes.
Okay. Oh really? And then, what are you doing? Is it just the record? Is it just the receipt? Or you do something else with the paper?
Yeah, the paper, I write the and I also put down what we are taking. If it is big, I write big. If it is selected, I write selected. Until when they are done, I have to read whatever they are taking. And I give them invoice and get my money from what they are taking.
Oh, I see. And your scale, you also supervise that or you have another person that does that?
I supervise my scale.
Oh,
you
I see.
Three people actually.
Okay, three
also,
people.
Dan Ladi is also involved.
Oh, I see.
So you have we have also people around to check that they don't steal the fish direct.
Oh, who are those ones?
See this man over there. He's one of our staff.
Mr. Bricci?
Mr. Bricci. Okay. He's also checking.
I see. So, yes, Mr. Willie, we just left your sales point and then you told me we should come this way. What is going on here?
Because today we will do some mathematics.
Okay.
And what I want to know is how much the cost is of feeding.
Okay.
Because feeding is in our farm 80% of our cost.
Interesting.
So, I don't know exactly the price of the feed. Let me go to my shop, let me see what the price of the feed is. Is cutting and also Olam. Yeah, so this farm is using Olam at the moment.
Okay.
And can you tell me how much we are paying for Olam in our farm? Do you have the price?
Yeah, of course I do.
For 4 mm. Let's take 4 mm out there. Yeah.
7,800 on the average.
Okay.
White 6 mm around 75 on the average.
I see.
That's the cost of the feed.
And this has been the price for a period of time now?
It fluctuates. In fact, you might even get it maybe 16 naira or 19 naira cheaper, or it's just around that second price.
Okay, just for the record, today's date is what?
Today is 29th of April. I can get it around 7-8
okay.
for the 4 mm and 7-5 for the 6 mm.
I see.
With the last 2 months, the feed price has gone up with 20%. So the raw material cost has gone up very fast. So the price of fish feed has also gone up very fast. That's also we are trying to maximize our price of our fish so that we still have a gross margin.
I see. So Mr. Francis, what has the patronage, I mean for your feeds, been like? How are you able to manage your customers considering this fluctuation in price? Are they all understanding, or how has it been? Tell me about the market.
They are not happy about the increment, but they have no choice because they have to buy the feed. If they don't buy the feed, they cannot feed their fish. So that's a problem. So what they do at the end of the day is to try and increase the price of the table size after production. So that's the way they try to balance things up.
I see.
And there is a little impact. For those that are stuck juvenile every month, there is this consideration not to stock too much or stock little or not even stock at all. So it's affecting the juvenile aspect. But things are coming up again because the rain has started falling, so people are considering coming back to the business. So as long as people need to eat, they will still have to come back. They don't have any choice. So have any choice.
Nice one. Thank you so much. Okay, yeah, I'm going to meet with Mr. Wally to ask him a couple of questions about how he's able to ensure that they get the best during the harvest. Good day, Mr. Wale.
You're welcome, sir.
Yes, sir. So, sorry if you don't mind, I just want to ask a few questions about how you are able to ensure that we don't record losses and records are properly kept because of your harvest. Can you just tell me, usually, how do you organize your team?
Yeah, what we normally do every Thursday, if you want to have a seat, our boys will make sure they release the water from the outlets.
Okay.
And close the inlets.
Okay.
When we get to a particular level, we normally release the water over 2/3 of the volume.
Okay.
So that the fish will not be stressed.
Okay.
We need to remove much of the water from the fish.
Okay.
When they are harvesting, you have to do the test, like a test weight.
Hmm.
We count, we record the weight, then we count. We divide the kilo by the number of pieces and get the average weight.
Interesting. So I guess that's what you've been doing there. I see a book. Okay. Oh.
This is what I'm doing here.
I see. So, I hope my camera can view this. Okay.
Like now, if I want to know the average weight, I've already done this one. 60 divided by 60 kilo divided by the number. This is the number.
Yes.
And this is the kilo. 60 divided by 39. You get like a 1.5 kilo.
I see. This is interesting.
Just to get the average.
So how much we sold out so far?
So for as of now, we are sold for 481, approximately 4.5.
Our estimation for this
estimation for, according to the tank report, is 5.3.
Okay. Interesting. Interesting.
5.5. We still have fish in our tank.
Okay, we still have some.
Yeah, estimated. That is expected.
Okay.
Yes, plus or minus.
Yes.
Because we don't normally get it accurate like that.
I see. So far, so good. We can say the harvest today is a success. Can we say that?
My special case of God, the way I'm looking at it, is going to be a success. Because now, what is there, I think I can even have very close to 1 ton. So if I combine it with 4.5, I think we'll be there.
Thank you so much for your time, sir.
Thank you.
So, Mr. Willy, I can see that you look quite exhausted from a very busy day, I must say.
Yeah, we start selling our fish since 7 o'clock in the morning.
Oh.
Now we are on... what is the time now? 12 o'clock.
Oh, I see.
So we were able to sell almost 5,000 kilo
okay.
in 5 hours' time.
Sorry, what are you looking at exactly?
Today we sold.
Okay.
But now I want to know what gross margin did we make from our fish.
Interesting.
And what is the gross margin for me is the turnover from the fish minus the cost of feed.
Okay, the turnover?
So the turnover of my fish.
Okay.
Yeah, the value of all the fish we sold.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Minus
all the feed we have been giving to the fish.
Interesting.
That means my manager, Wally, he spoke with you before when
yes.
he was harvesting.
Yes.
He has given me the books.
Interesting.
Yeah. That's why the record keeping comes in very important.
I see.
I always tell people, going to the church without the Bible is the same thing as farming fish without record keeping.
Mm.
Because you don't have any direction.
I see.
You don't know where you're going to.
I see.
You don't know if the feed you're using is good. Where are my problems?
Interesting.
Do you understand?
Interesting.
So this part of the video is actually the most important part.
The moment of truth, right?
That's why I'm writing it down.
Yes.
The moment of truth. First of all, I go to Wally's record.
Hmm.
You can see from this book.
Hmm.
Can I show it to you?
Yeah. Okay.
This pond we are harvested today is tank 14.
Okay.
We stock them on the 6th of October.
Okay.
Yep. We stocked 4,210 pieces.
Okay.
And the fish were not big. They were just 24 gram. So we stocked 100 kilo. Because this 100 kilo is not a part of the growth.
Mm.
You understand?
Yes.
What you're harvesting, you have to take out 100 kilo.
I see.
Because we already started with 100 kilo.
I see.
Yeah, so you have to be honest to yourselves.
6th of October, and today is 29th of yes. April. Isn't that?
To be honest, the number of days yes. is close to 200 days.
Yes.
That okay. is, let me say, 6 months.
6 months. Okay.
And that is long.
Yes.
On the other hand, the fish are very big.
It's yeah. obvious.
And yeah? we stock them small.
And we stock them small.
I
know the reason why. You know, in Nigeria, in November, December, now let me say December, January, even a part of February, we have Harmattan.
Hmm. Indeed.
Is it not?
Yes.
In the Harmattan, our water temperature was less than 25 degrees. So the intake of feed was not high.
I see.
So that's why the fish stay a bit longer than normally.
I see.
Because I know the next pond we are selling, they're not up to that age. They're even up to maybe 160 days. They're even less, 1 month less. On the other hand, the fish are quite big.
It's obvious. It's yeah. obvious. So now, in trying to really know
okay.
if we did anything good yet today, I mean, evaluating your topic.
Margin.
Yes.
Okay.
I want you to tell me.
Okay, now, then I will start from Wally's book.
Okay.
I have fed those fish in that period 6,710 kilo of feed.
Okay.
You can see it. He's recording it. He's recording the daily feed gift.
I see.
Do you see that?
This is a very detailed work.
Every day you write it down.
I see the dates, I see.
Total feed and this accumulated feed.
Accumulated
feed,
day
okay.
Feed.
Yeah, so that.
Total feed per day and accumulated feed.
Yeah, accumulated feed.
Okay.
That is
so that at the moment you are finished, you don't have to calculate every day together.
I see.
It's already there. 6,710 kg he fed.
That was what he fed tank 14 for the period yeah. of between
to
the
end.
All those days yes. was total feed.
Okay.
6,710 kg.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's interesting.
Now, we want to know this the harvest.
Sorry, if I may ask, what was the total number of fishes that were stocked on, I mean, within the period?
We stocked on that October 4,200 pieces.
Yeah, 4,200 pieces.
Okay.
We are coming later on this one.
Okay.
Because we also want to know the mortality rate or the survival rate.
Okay.
Yes? So this is the figure which is very important because this is all the money.
Yes.
That is 80% of our money is in the feed. All the other costs are not so much.
Okay.
So, Wally gave me, the harvest.
Okay.
But unfortunately, we were not finished to finish the complete pond.
I see.
So, Wally was able to harvest and bring to the sales point.
Okay.
4,990 kilo.
Mm.
But we still have a leftover.
I see.
Of 350 kilo.
Okay.
Yeah?
Okay.
So our total fish in that pond, for the sake of today and doing this exercise, yeah, I consider that we harvested the whole pond.
Yes.
So I add that fish which is left over, I add it to the harvest. Okay?
Yeah.
There's 350 kilo. Can you read this?
Yes, very clear.
So I have 540 kilo. Is a harvest.
I see.
Now, what is my growth? It's 5,340. Minus my initial stocking.
Yes.
You follow that?
Yes, I'm with you.
Dominic?
Yes, I'm with you.
I stock 100 kilos, so that is not a part of my growth.
Yes.
I have to minus it.
Okay.
That is the initial stock.
Okay.
So that means I have a growth of 2,400 kg.
Okay.
Now you see something. This is what I harvest, and so, this is what is my growth.
Okay.
This is my benefit, so to say.
Yes.
And for this one, I use this amount of feed.
Yes. You use 6,710 kg.
So now you ask yourself, for 1 kilo of fish, how much feed do I need? Because this is the only important factor,
yes,
in your farm.
Yes.
For 1 kilo of fish, how much feed do I need?
Good.
That means this figure, I have to divide it by this figure.
Okay.
You follow that?
Yes.
So, feed divided by growth. And we call that the feed conversion ratio.
Oh, yeah.
This is the figure everybody should understand. This, everybody should understand this. How much feed do I need to grow one kilo of fish?
Interesting.
Because when we are coming to that point, we can also make it into money.
Yes.
So let me use my calculator.
Okay. This is really practical, I must say. And then this would really help us know where we stand.
Okay. 6710 divided by 5240.
Okay.
So, once again, what does it mean? 1.28.
Okay.
1.28 means I need 1.28 kilo of feed to grow 1 kilo of fish.
Interesting.
Now, your question should be now, how much is the cost of feed? You went already to my shop.
Yes.
And the shop was telling us the average price of feed, because we use 4, 6 and 3. Let me say, when you take the price of the 4 mm.
Yes.
That was 7,800 for 15 kilo.
Okay.
Yeah. 800 naira.
Yes.
For 15 kilo. So how much is that per kilo?
So we divide?
7,800 divided by 15. Is 520 naira per kilo.
Interesting.
Yeah?
Yes.
The cost of feeding for 1 kilo of fish, I have to multiply 1.28 by 520.
I see.
You understand?
Yes,
me?
Yes.
I hope the people who are going for this video, they can follow me.
Because
if you don't follow this thing, just watch the video again and again till you understand.
Good.
Because this is the way you can calculate if you're making some little change or you're not making anything.
Or you're wasting your time.
Correct, you can better start doing something else. 520 times 1.28. So, to produce 1 kilo of fish on feed cost only.
Okay.
I need 666 naira per kg for fish.
Interesting.
What is your next question when you see this?
When I see this, then I can see, what then should I sell at?
Aha! So what is your sales price?
Yes.
Correct?
Yes.
Now, my sales price, with the size of fish I have, which is close to 1.5 kilo, yeah, is 819 naira.
Okay.
Sorry, the wind is messing us up.
Yeah.
So sales is 819 naira per kg.
Okay.
And that is an average sales price. Because I have fish of 920, I have fish of 940.
Okay.
I have also fish of 860.
Okay.
Okay. I've already explained the cost of a kilo of fish.
Okay.
The produce a kilo with 666 naira. With our sales price, however, is 890 naira.
As at today, what date today?
April 29, 2021.
Okay.
Nigeria, Abuja.
Okay.
Because everywhere can the price be different.
Certainly.
Because
certainly.
In Port Harcourt the price will be higher than this. In Ibadan the price will be lower than this.
Of course.
So Abuja we are talking about average price 890 naira per kilo. And that is an average of smaller fish and bigger fish. Okay. My biggest fish is going for 940. My smallest fish is going for 840.
Oh, so you mean you sell different sizes of fishes at different prices.
Yes. That is not what the harvesting people are doing.
Yeah.
This, you have seen them, they are selecting there.
Okay.
At the sales point.
Yes. Okay, different customers have their preferences.
Yeah. Yes. And big fish has higher price.
Oh, they are.
So our gross margin is 224 naira per kg.
How do you come about that?
It's 890 minus 666. Now, this pond today has given me a gross profit. Yeah?
Yes.
Today we sold, let's say, 5 tons to make it simple, but it is actually 5.3.
Okay.
We make it simple to 5 tons. Yeah?
I see.
So, 224 multiplied, wait, 224 multiplied by 5000 kilo. Is 1.1 million.
Interesting. 1.1 million naira.
2 million. And I told you, I sell on a weekly basis.
That is interesting. How are you able to do that?
Because when we finish our pond,
okay,
the next day we are stocking the fish which we need to stock this pond.
Yes.
You will see them in our farm.
Okay.
It's already prepared.
Oh, really?
My farm has no empty pond.
Wow.
I don't see empty pond in my farm. When I see empty pond in my farm, I will not be happy.
I see.
And Wally, my farm manager, has the same philosophy. You use what you have available.
Mm.
It's like a truck of 30 ton. You don't carry 10 ton or 5 ton. It's waste. Then my ponds are there and we want and I don't speculate. I always stock. Mm. I don't speculate and say maybe in 5 months time the price will be high or I don't stock because the price will be low. No. What we are after is efficient farming.
Beautiful.
I produce Beautiful. As much as possible.
That's interesting.
Regardless of market. Because I know I always sell my fish. If the fish is scarce, the price is high. If the fish is plenty, I have to lower my price.
Beautiful.
That means when the price is low, my gross margin will go down.
Mm.
But I'm not going down in my volumes. My volumes are always there.
Always there.
Okay, Dominique. I want to flap over. So we ended with this 1.12 million naira profit.
Yeah. Okay.
Gross profit.
Okay.
From the sales of that pond.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm selling every week.
Yeah, and then from pond 14. From tank 14, you were able to get 1.12. So
that's my gross margin.
Okay, that's your gross margin, and
I can do that at least 4 times in a month.
Okay.
So that makes 4.4 million.
That's a decent enough sales, I would say.
Yeah, the 4.4 million the gross margin, I still have to pay for my expenses in the farm.
Okay.
Labor.
Okay.
Energy.
Okay.
Water. And maintenance.
Yeah.
And some other things.
Yeah.
If I look at my accountancy report, my expenses, including the salaries, is not more than 1.1 million.
I see.
I think it's even below 1 million.
Okay.
So in a month, when you say there's 1 million expenses.
Yes.
That means my net profit is 3.4 million.
Mm.
Yeah. You
because my fingerlings, I don't count them as direct cost because it's a part of my farm activity.
I get.
That you is have... why I'm using electricity.
Why is my monthly expenses low?
Is because I don't use energy to get all this water.
I see.
In my farm.
I see.
Because it's a gravity-fed farm.
Interesting.
Yeah?
Interesting.
Because if it is not a gravity-fed farm, this 1 million could even be up to 1.5 or 1.7.
Yes, and that will account for the cost of powering the pumping machine.
The maintenance of the pumping machine.
Okay.
Of course, the energy.
Yeah.
Either electrical or a diesel pump.
Okay.
I don't have that. My water is flowing and my cost is limited.
Interesting.
I pay a flat rate to water board for raw water.
I see. So now...
That's why in our former discussion we had, I told you this location is a perfect location.
Indeed.
And
indeed.
You see my customers today?
Yes.
We were able to sell 5 tons.
It is incredible,
it's just
I must
a shame
say.
That we didn't sell over 300 kilo. With that one, we'll go tomorrow or on Saturday. Finish. All my fish is gone for that pump. I can restock. And the fish to restock is already there.
My pump
will not be empty for even 2 days. There's another thing we want to know.
Okay.
Is the survival rate. Yeah? Because
yes.
The survival rate also gives something about performance.
Exactly.
So, I told you. I stocked 4,200 pieces.
Yeah.
My average weight, I calculated from the book, from the sales report today.
Yeah.
Every first bubble, the kilos and the numbers are there.
Okay.
64 kilo, 41 pieces. You see that?
I see that.
So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, we have about 8 of them, or even more, there's even more. It's about 10 of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it gives me quite an accurate average weight. And
indeed.
The average weight of my fish was 1.5 kilos.
Yes. That is very good.
That was a good weight because that is what I like to sell. Because all the sizes are there. The big, the medium, the small, smallest,
yeah.
But not dry and smoked size, hardly any of them.
Okay.
Because these are the lower prices.
I see.
And even in Abuja, they like all those big sizes here inside town.
I so noticed
when
that.
When I have big sizes, they are more energetic than I have only small sizes. They have difficulty to sell them.
Mm.
You know, the big sizes, they go for barbecue.
Yeah.
You know, in the aluminium.
Yes, and that foil.
Yeah, in the foil. Yeah.
I
and
see.
Two people can eat one fish.
Exactly.
And if you cut them in pieces,
they
one fish can do 5 plates of pepper soup.
Indeed.
Anyway,
indeed.
After our session, we go for pepper soup.
Of course.
To promote our own business.
Of course, of course.
Now, I told you I have 5,340 kilo.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
What I sold and what is left over. To know the number of fish, I have to divide the biomass, this is called biomass.
Okay.
Divided by the average weight.
Biomass divided by average weight?
Yes.
Will give you
the number of fish.
Oh.
So, that means 5,340 divided by 1.5.
Okay.
I've already done that. Is 3,000 pieces. So I stocked this fish 199 days ago.
Yes.
4,200. And I only got back 3,560.
Hmm. Was that margin a big one?
What do we? My survival rate is 85%.
Hmm.
Because it's 3,560 divided by 4,200 times 100.
Exactly.
It's making 85%. That is actually not very good. Because we normally get 90%. But the good thing is it didn't affect
our profit, the profit. Gross profit.
Yes.
But it could have been better. See, when you lose fish, if you lose them when they are small,
yes,
the economic impact is not high.
Oh.
Yeah? Because you have not given them much feed.
Exactly, exactly.
But if you lose them before selling, every kilo is a big loss.
I get.
Yeah?
I get.
So, I told you already, we stock our fish very small.
Yes.
About 23 grams. They stayed quite long because of the hamatan and the cold water. All this has affected. You know, the mortality in the pond.
Yes.
Yeah? Is not up to this amount. It's not up to 700 pieces.
Yes.
The fish disappeared in a different way.
How?
It's the birds.
Oh.
Nowadays, when we stock small fish, we use bird netting.
I see.
Because this size of fish of 23 grams, those birds,
the birds
like
will come
it.
And pick them up. Is it those, those hammerhead birds?
Hammerhead, and there's some other ones.
Oh.
The heron. We have different types. And you know, we are here in an area where there's a lot of water. We have a river, we have the lake, the dam. So there's a lot of birds.
I see.
And they go very high and see the fish from very high. They immediately spot the place where the fish are smallest. And they come and eat.
You take them out.
So that's why this year we started with bird netting.
Bird netting, I get.
And but we normally get even better results. We get 90 to 95%.
So can we hope that by sometime maybe in June, when you will be doing the harvest of the fishes you stocked sometime in January, we should even get better
survival
rates, right?
So okay. The survival rate, if you have the bird netting,
yes,
and you don't have mortality. You have graded the fish very well.
Okay, that
so
is another thing.
The shooters and the grading can also be part of the problem that you don't get the fish back because fish are cannibalizing.
Oh.
All this in mind, and you have done everything well, and you don't get the result, that is the moment you have to start thinking about theft. These are the birds without feather.
So when you rule out the birds with feather, you rule out cannibalism.
Yeah.
And there's no, I mean, what other factor? Cannibalism?
Well graded
yes,
fish.
Well graded.
No diseases.
No diseases.
Then there's a time to think what is going on in my farm.
Oh.
Okay.
The birds without feather.
Yes, that is how I want to end my lecture for today.
Oh, I see.
Everybody now start record keeping.
Okay.
Without record keeping, you will never get focused on your farm. You will not know what you are making.
Yes.
And you cannot improve your business.
Indeed.
So please, everybody who is doing this business, start doing this.
Thank you so much, Mr. Willy. I must congratulate you too on a very successful harvest today.
Thank you.
We look forward to the next video as you continue to share your wealth of experience with the world. Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome.